Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout. We are here with Erwin and not taking his quest right now. I'll have to remember to come back to him later. On closer examination, you realize that you won't be taking your bath in this tub after all. Well, it is in someone else's house, is that? So yeah, I had a premonition that if we try to go in there, or try to fulfill his need, a pile of rotted and weathered wood, not worth its weight in, well, anything. Might be some more stuff over here, maybe. Psst, come here. Yeah, if I take his quest, I have a feeling it's not going to go well, so maybe we should come back when we've learned things. By the way, do I have to take more... Skill point 0. Okay, I am leveled up then. Level 5. I can take another perk next level. And of course more skill points. You see a shifty looking character. So, what you doing in the hop? Looking for something that I need? Well, we got all needs. I might be able to help with some of them. So what sort of needs do you got? I have need of some information. So you're looking for information, huh? Being a respectable businessman, I got overhead. So I'll need a few caps to tell what you need to know. Now that we got that straight, what do you want to know about? Anything you know about water chips that you can tell me? So you think I might know a little about those water chip things, huh? Well, you might be right. It's gonna cost you, though. I think 500 bottle caps ought to do it. Too rich for my blood. Not a problem. Is there anything else you might be wanting? You come talk to Lemmy first. Well, you don't resemble someone from the band Motorhead, so you're not my kind of Lemmy. What do you know about Decker? Now, normally I don't mind selling information, but you're not going to get anything out of Lemmy about Mr. Decker. Okay, but can I ask you about some other things? Sure, what else do you want to know about? I'm looking for a certain commodity, if you know what I mean. Stuff for needs, huh? Well, I know there's a guy over in Old Town that could probably fix you up some stuff like that. But you know what? He needs to know who you are before you show up at his doorstep. Let me guess, this invite is going to cost me? Exactly. So I'm thinking, only for you, of course, 1,000 caps so you can talk to this guy without him blowing your head off first. Can't afford that. Not a problem. If there's anything else you might be wanting, you come talk to Lemmy first. Okay. For all I know, you don't know crap. Station close to the house. Leon. Give me a break. No one can bust a knee or break fingers. Until the boss says so. Who cares about shock value? We ain't artists. We're professionals. Leon, someone's trying to talk to us. Aren't we supposed to kill them if they do that? Not until the boss says so. Just ignore her and she'll go away. I ain't paid to talk. They're supposed to kill us? I hope we can actually go in here. Wait. Dog's blocking the way, thank you. He's still blocking the way. Lorenzo. A bank door, huh? Hi. Wait. Sorry. Don't kill me. I just wanted to look at the desk. I hate when I do that. Well, if it ain't a potential customer, I'm Lorenzo the Munificent at your service. I give out loans. Only 10% daily interest. And, a maximum of 10 days to repay. You won't find a more generous lending institution anywhere in the hub. Actually, I was hoping you could share some information. Well, I suppose. What do you need to know about? Tell me about Decker. He's a great guy. A good source of jobs to pay off my loans. Tell him I sent you. You might get a bonus. Bonus? What do you mean? Well, maybe not a bonus, but he's a great guy. Trust me on that one. What about the children of the cathedral? I can't say I'm too impressed. I run an honest, respectable business, and they accuse me of being a thief. They're never those people. They think a vow of poverty gives them the right to judge me. Vow of poverty? I'll bet their leader, this Morpheus character, he's not broke. No, sir. I bet that over in L.A. Boneyard, he's just living it up. Morpheus? Is he looking for someone named Neo? What about those missing caravans? Deathclaw. It's gotta be the Deathclaw. No one's safe anymore. What about the Deathclaw? Man, some of those stories they say about that thing are just... Well, there's something. What about the local police? They're great guys. It's true we have the occasional misunderstanding, but I think that they're a credit to their... species. Sarovos? Whichever one that is. It's a kind of, like, a voice. I don't know what it's supposed to be sounding like. Misunderstandings like what? Can you believe someone accused me of extortion? Fortunately, my good friend Decker set them straight. Tell me about yourself. I'm just a respectable businessman, that's all. We at Giovanni's have been respectable businessmen since the days before the Holocaust. Now that's tradition. That sounds like a kind of challenging thing to say. Where does a person find work around here? You should try Mr. Decker. Exciting work at great prices. The best in town. And he's just across the street. You can't get better convenience than that. What kind of excitement? Adventure. Danger. You can really make a killing. Literally. Well, bye. See you around, pal. He's a pretty upbeat character, isn't he? This is a neon sign for the Maltese Falcon. Yep, across the street is a general store. Guns, I haven't been in here yet. Don't know if I'll buy anything, but... This is a weapon shop. It's run by Beth. She's good for guns, but better for gossip. Oh, good. Stuff. Beth, owner of the weapon shop. Hi there, how can I help you? Is there any place in town I should avoid? Oh yes, you ought to stay as far away from the Maltese Falcon as you possibly can. Decker and his greasy lapdog, Kane, are bad news. They'll eat you alive if you're not careful. I'd also give Lorenzo at the Friendly Lending Company a wide berth. I just talked to him. How does someone make money around here? Well, I'm not hiring, but there's a job post in the center of the merchant market. You might want to check there. Can I ask you some... I wish I could get a day off. It's been so lovely out. Back so soon? Yeah, can I ask you some questions? Of course you can. Don't be silly. Aw. Sweet. Can you tell me about Decker? Now, there's someone you don't ever want to mess with. He scares me. He owns the Maltese Falcon. Why do you say it like that? He owns the Maltese Falcon. Sorry, it just reminds me of a friend that used to own it before him. Decker wanted it really bad, but my friend wouldn't sell. 2 days later, they find him dead in the back alley of Old Town. Why do you think Decker's responsible? My friend was a clean freak. He wouldn't come within 100 yards of Old Town. He was shot with a magnum pistol. No one in Old Town could afford one of those. Plus, he was shot once in the head and twice in the back. Does that sound like a robbery? My friend was just trying to get his life back. Sorry to hear that. Is there anything else I can do for you? What can you tell me about the different merchants? Well, there are the three main merchant shops, the Water Merchants, the Crimson Caravan, and the Fargo Traders. They also run the City Council. What do you want to know about? The Water Merchants. They're in charge of all the water. Shocker. Greedy people. I wouldn't want to work for them. Their pay is the worst and the jobs are just as bad. Do they always control all the water? No. From what I heard, a while back a group of merchants seized control of the water tower and proclaimed that they were the water merchants, and people had to get water from them. The merchant war raged on for years until a man named Roy Green, yeah, Justin's grandfather, that's it, helped to negotiate an agreement that ended the war. What kind of agreement? Well, he set up the city council and set a limit on the price of water. Personally, I think they should have beat the tar out of them. Oh, sorry, I mean they should have showed them who's boss. Thanks. Another question about the merchants. The Crimson Caravan. The Crimson Caravan, a bunch of crazy people. They will do any job, no matter what the risk. I'm surprised they aren't missing more caravans than they are. They're missing caravans, too? Actually, all the merchants have had a few caravans disappear. The Fargo traders are just unlucky, I suppose. How risky. They will pass right through an area known to be attacked by raiders. They charge a lot, so they can hire extra hands. The pay is great, but you have to be alive to spend it, right? And what about the Fargo traders? The Fargo traders pay well and their jobs aren't too deadly. Butch owns the shop. A good man. They're fair and let me do as I please with the place. I like working with them. Plus you get a discount on anything you buy here if you work for Butch. Something to keep in mind. What about the city council? There are six representatives, two from each of the main merchant groups. Everything needs at least four votes to be passed. They can never agree on anything. Thanks for all the information. Rumors. You had rumors. I want to ask you about rumors. It's under questions. Plus, I might sell some things too. Have you heard any good rumors? No, that's all. Was there anything else you wanted to talk about? I have something to sell. Well, let's see. I'm supposed if I ask something I want to buy, it's the same. And what's his name? Shotgun. A traitor. Let me just see something. I know shotgun is probably more... 8 to 20. Hunting rifle. Range 40. 12 to 22. Range 14. A Winchester Widowmaker double barrel 12 gauge shotgun. Short barrel with mahogany grip. It has 0 out of 2 shots of 12 gauge shotgun shells. Weighs 5 pounds. Yeah, the range and the fact that you have to keep reloading the thing. So often. I'm gonna sell the shotgun. You wanna buy something? Let's get down to business. So same window comes up. 800 caps. I was gonna say dollars. Beer. Take my beer, please. 12 gauge shotgun shells. I was selling the shotgun, so we might as well sell all the shells with it. How many bottle caps? We're almost there, right? Keys, we need those. I'm gonna carry around the extra armor in case come across another party member that might need one. Geiger counter, pretty cool. I'll keep a spare gun just in case. Nuka-Cola. Yep. I'll sell a few of these. Not a few. I'm used to the big button being okay or sell or something. I'll sell a few of these as well. What are we up to? We've got plenty. Just to try to free up some wheat, you know? I don't use these. This is for a 44 Magnum. Armor piercing. I'm gonna hold on to that as well. 10mm though. I sold my gun for 10mm. I don't even have that. Wait, let me see. What kind of gun is this and what does it take? Oh, submachine gun. Okay, I'll keep that and the rounds. Yeah, I'll go for that. Now, what is she selling here? BBs? 12 get. There's a. Probably the stuff I sold her. What we got here? Throwing knife. A knife balanced specifically for throwing, made of titanium and laser sharpened. Grenades. Right, right, right. We have some of those. How much are those? Oh my god. They are expensive. I'm gonna move 4. Damn. There's 3 grenades, almost as much as all this stuff I have here. What else we got? Someone told me the crowbar can be useful, probably for prying things open. And we're already over our limit. I'm assuming this is the same kind of gun. You're telling me, like, pistol, sledgehammer, spear, a club, a military or police baton, heavy wood. Metal armor. Polished metal plates, crudely forming a sort of armor, provides better protection than all leather armors, but slows the wearer's mobility somewhat. This model features spikes added to the shoulder, a popular fashion statement. Isn't there a strength for this? I don't even know if I can wear that. Leather. Yeah, how do I? How do I move that down? I don't know. Alright, we're good here. Guess I'm gonna have to add some more stuff here. Just a bit more. I just round it up with some bottle caps. 20. No, we need 19, right? Yeah, 19 bottle caps. 0, 1, 9. Cool. I did have some things I want to get rid of, so we've done that. Sweet! Got some more frag grenades. I should probably start using those. Better, better. So, let's check out the general store then. I'm just randomly. Okay. I can't look at nothing here. Mitch. Of the all-in-one store. How may I help you today? I'd like to buy something. Great. Here's what I have. Short and to the point. What we got here? Radaway? A chemical solution that bonds with radiation particles and passes them through your system. Takes time to work. Huh. A radio. A model 2043B radio communicator from the fine people at Watts Electronics. Dependable, rugged, and camouflaged with the optional RS-121 interface. Huh. Huh. Flamethrower fuel? We can get a flamethrower in this game? That's freaking awesome. A cylinder containing an extremely flammable liquid fuel for flamethrowers. Yeah, no kidding. I'm just curious. Oh, times 10. I guess that's one canister of fuel or something. 10 doses. This is expensive, the rat away. $625 for the radio. This looks like a different kind of knife, is it? A high quality combat knife. The Stellona is from Sharpwit, Inc. The edge of the blade is manufactured sharp for over a decade of use. Nuka-Cola. Rope. Super Stim Pack. Ooh, really? This I might be interested in. Because that Stim Pack... Yeah, we could not keep up with the Raiders. Whoever those guys were. The damage they were doing. I healed myself and then they killed me in the next round. Also referred to as simply a super stim, this is a very advanced and powerful piece of healing technology. While it is capable of healing even severe wounds and major tissue damage, it also causes some internal hemorrhaging to the something or other, which I can't read. Because... Can I move that? Why am I... I'm clicking on that and it's moving that. I don't know. So how much is this? Just one. Alright. I'm thinking I got two of them. Because we could use some, like, quicker healing. What's this? Psycho? A unique delivery system filled with strange and unknown chemicals of probably military origin. It is supposed to increase the combat potential of a soldier. Is that a curiosity? How much is one? Expensive. Scout handbook. First aid book. Supposedly we can read books? Oh, Dean's Electronics? I don't know how, though. Big Book of Science. Which, I'm sad I've sold all my books. Is a motion... motion sensor for the Pip-Boy! Yeah, baby! Let me look at this, though. A set of books containing information about different scientific fields. A study book of the on the field for electronics. A note on the cover says that it's for the budding young electrician in everyone. Motion sensor. A Watts Electronics ICU model motion sensor detects the movement of biological material over a distance of 300 meters using a tuned radar device. Sweet. How much is one?
Good God.
I'll put that bat for now. I think I want to get that, though. Geiger counter. They're selling rocks. How much do they sell a rock for? It's a rock. The granite ink model is an upgraded version. 2232 for free. They just give you rock. Okay. I guess it's considered a promotional item. Put the rock up there now. Anything else? Mentats. What we got here? Multi-tool? A super tool set containing various useful tools and gadgets. The aspiring engineer or repairman should never leave home without it. Looks good for, like, repairing things, right? This crap's expensive. Can we afford it? That's the question. I've determined I want to keep at least, well, some of this stuff. We can technically afford it. How much are these fruits? Ten each. I'll keep them. Just curious. Grenades. yeah, I'm gonna buy this crap because we're probably gonna need... The motion sensor's gonna be really handy. These will be good to survive, and this will probably be really useful for repairing something. That's pretty much... We've got four things for like over $2,500. So... In order to... Get this stuff... I need to go $9.99. And then... $9.99. Strange, I get to do it like this. $19.98. I don't feel like doing it in my head, so... 600. Okay, and I just have to... Subtract... What, 9, right? Sweet. We got stuff. We got stuff. Now, pit point. How do we know? You know, this isn't the active map, is it? This is the map. So, this is us? Scanner. Do I have to use it? All right. So these are all the life forms. So now when we go to Pip-Boy, is it automatically here? Actually, no, I want to go map. You're kidding. I have to use it. Can I just install it on the thing? There should be a way. Alright. I'm done here. Comes in caravan, we've been there. Maltese Falcon. Before I go in the Maltese Falcon, let's check. What's this? Nothing, right? You cannot get through the door with cane here. With cane here? Where's cane? Who is cane? Why did I think we were trying to get through a door? I was trying to go around. You determined that this vehicle will never drive again. Really? Useless junk. Tires. Old barrel made from steel. I think I've looked at everything else in this section here. Except for the Maltese Falcon. Don't touch that door if you want to live. I'm the only one that can open that door. Well, is this Kane? Well, that's a shifty looking character. Is there somebody over here with the overhang that we can't see? Okay, so he's got gambling here. Before I even go in here, that's Kane. That's the bartender. Kane? I've heard of you. You're the one that took out Gizmo over in Junktown. Killian must have paid a good sum for that job. Are you here for some work, maybe? Sorry, maybe later. But of course, good day. They thought we were trying to go through that door. Who knows? Maybe we were pathing through there. So don't try to go through there. We got a bartender. Yeah, what do you want? Water. That'd be two caps. Okay. Here, the bartender slides you a dirty tin cup full of some strange, murky water. After drinking the water, you have a strange taste in your mouth. Yeah, we'll beat it. Nice. You see a drunk. Hail, drunk. You're my bestest friend. Hick. Roulette. This is a gambling table. Craps table. You see a very upset gambler? All upset gamblers. I'll beat this damn game yet. I think they're cheating. I'm not gonna bet this time. Slot machine. I'll bet two caps, why not? Better luck next time, no thanks. Who's in these rooms? Can I go in these rooms? I'll just get killed. He just ran in. Okay. You see a sleazy looking woman. Hey there, sweet pea. Sleazy. Suit yourself, sugar. You'll be back. No diseases. I'm clean. Sure you are. I got the caps. I'm in. I like it rough if you're into that. Locked. I do groups for a little extra. I hope you're not thinking about our dog. There's a bookcase. Alright. Just seeing if there's anything else here. Anyone else here? Locked. What about these rooms? Oh, back door. Crimson Caravan. Alright. I am a little interested here. What the hell goes on? How much does the fun cost? For you, sugar? 10 caps. Sounds good. What you looking for, darling? I don't care. Anything and everything surprised me. I'm really just curious what happens here. Alright, follow me. Thanks, stranger. She pockets the caps and blows you a kiss. Thanks for the good time. I'll see you later. Okay. Do I have some kind of disease now? I have all my hit points. Alright. I seem to be okay. I didn't gain any experience either, I noticed that. Well. There aren't many games in this day and age when you can do that. With the exception of Grand Theft Auto, I suppose. I just had to try, guys, so... So wasn't that the Maltese Falcon? Yeah. Well, I didn't run into the proprietor. So stay tuned for next episode when we walk into, well, the next area. Maybe meet the water merchants. Possibly. We've seen a lot of this place, a lot of different merchants here, and well, they're the ones we're really looking for, aren't they? Thanks so much for watching. See you next time, guys, and always seek adventure.